We are gathered here to marry Jane Mancini and Chris Marchette under the watchful eye of the Almighty. If there is anyone here who believes there's any reason these two should not be wed, speak now or forever hold your peace.
I sure as hell think it's a lousy idea.
Michael.
What is this, a joke?
No joke, kangaroo boy. We're here to put an end to this charade.
Get the hell out of here, both of you. This is none of your business.
Oh, the welfare of the company is my business. And Jane, it's obvious that this guy is attaching himself to you in order to get more control over our little enterprise.
You're sick. You're just trying to keep me from being happy.
Out, or we'll call the police.
That's what I told him, but he's so impulsive.
You don't want to do that, Chris. I heard about the attempted rape you pulled on Sydney. Did you know this, Jane? Yes, the poor girl was working alone, and Mr. Outback here jumps her.
What?
It's a lie.
No, it's against the law, big guy.
Get out of my life, Michael. Leave me alone.
You're way over the line, mister.
And what are you going to do about it? Get physical? I'm not some skinny little redhead. Now, you can go ahead and have your affair with Jane, but you keep your hands out of her wallet. And I really don't care what you do with the rest of her.
You've ruined this. Are you happy?
You'll thank me for it later.
Rotten hell. Both of you.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Now, that's what I call investment counseling.
And it was kind of fun, too. And now, since we're here and we've got a minister and everything.
Oh, Kimberly, you know, I don't think it's a very good time.
Michael, you proposed to me, and after everything I've been through with you, don't you think I deserve a little something? Besides, can you think of two people who deserve each other more?
You're right. Let's do it. Padre, I think it's time to do the deed.
How in hell did those two mental cases ever find us?
I don't.